Isaiah chapter 27, commencing from verse 1. On that day,
which is today,
the Lord will use his powerful and deadly sword.
God himself is here. Jehovah God is here. He will use his powerful sword
to punish Leviathan.
To punish that juju, that Leviathan, that demon, that ghost husband, that ghost wife that appeared to you in the dream, that snake, that boy you are seeing in your dream, that rat, that pussy, that owl that you are seeing in your dream. When you sleep, you'll be seeing it. Or anything that is disturbing you. Only God will handle the battle.
Amen.
He will use his deadly sword to kill that rat.
Amen.
Kill that cat.
Amen.
Kill that snake.
Amen.
Kill that boy.
Amen.
Kill that owl.
Amen.
That owl.
Amen.
Must die today.
Amen.
That dog that coming to dig your compound. The deadly sword of God himself will use to kill it.
Amen.
Anything that coming to terrify you in your dream. That mad demon that coming to terrify you in your dream, the hand of God will destroy that evil spirit.
Amen.
And your way will open.
Amen.
Or anybody that coming to you in the dream to sleep with you sexually, you want to live a holy life, the day you say you will give yourself to God, somebody will come and sleep with you in the dream, coming to play love with you as if it's your husband or it's your wife. The mighty hand of God, the sword of God, will kill that demon today.
Amen.
And we know that you are free.
Amen.
And it is already dead. You will never have those dreams again.
Yes. That wriggling, twisting dragon.
That wiggly, twisting dragon that nobody can deal with, God will deal with it today.
And to kill the monster that lives in the sea.
That monster in the sea, that controls the sea. That dirty game. Any demon try you, coming from the water, you see yourself in the water, you see yourself in the water, God should kill it now.
Amen.
That monster in the sea that causes problem in your life, that say you come and serve him, that you come and do this, that they dream, that they see him, if they follow you, as I'm talking, because you are free now, God should kill it in Jesus' name.
Amen. On that day, the Lord will say of his pleasant vineyard.
Then that is today. God accepted all of us. We that were suffering before, God will say, my blessed vineyard. We are the blessed vineyard of who?
Of God.
The vineyard of God, the vine God planted. Can anybody uproot it?
No.
The vine only God planted. Can anybody uproot it? Today, God is saying to all of us, the vineyard of God that he already planted. Nobody can uproot you again. You are blessed.
Amen.
No dream of death again. Say, I am the plant of God.
I am the plant of God.
I am the vineyard of God.
I am the vineyard of God.
I am the plant God planted. Nobody can uproot me.
Nobody can uproot me.
No animal can eat my leaves away. No beast can eat my leaves. No beast can take away my fruit. I am the vineyard of God.
I am the plant of God.
That he has planted in his vineyard. God will water me. God will make me well. My leaves will not wither.
I will bear fruit.
I will not struggle. God will give me freedom. I will grow very well. I will bosom very well. My leaves will be very green. My fruit will be very robust. Because God is the one who planted me. He will care for me. Nobody can uproot me.
I am
the plant of God.
I am the plant of God.
In the vineyard of God.
I am free.
I will bear fruit. No animal can disturb my fruit. No dry season can harm me. God will water me. I remain free. I will not struggle. I will not struggle in life. The day has come. for my freedom.
For my freedom.
What was disturbing me? God has destroyed it. God has given me all my heart's desire. Glory be to God. I will not suffer again. I am free. In Jesus' name. Okay, finish it.
On that day, the Lord will say of his pleasant vineyard.
Today, now, God said to his pleasant vineyard. Yeah, we are the pleasant one. Very pleasant one, very fine one. We.
And wash over it and water it continually.
God will wash over us and water us continuously. Can you understand that? God will wash over us and water us continually.